What's going on, Bucs family? This is your boy Travis checking in. I know I'm not as active on the page. A lot has been going on this year, but I am always and forever supporting the Buccaneers and Buccos Locker. A huge shout out to Isaiah for holding it down. We're almost at 1,000 subscribers, but enough about that. Let's get into this episode of Hard Knocks. If you haven't seen it, this was a great way to start the series of Hard Knocks, following Jameis, going back to his hometown, checking in with his family, showing where he came from. He had a hard road. He had a hard life coming up, man. Country boy, had no shame. He has come up. He's still active in his family's life. Checked in with Gerald McCoy, family man. Everybody in Tampa, showing DeSean Jackson. This was a great episode, y'all. I like how they show what's going on. They're introducing these great players who are supposed to lead this team. Jameis, of course, Gerald McCoy, Quan and his hair color, man. I'll look past it. Some things that highlights of the show. I like how they touched up on DeSean Jackson and him linking up with Mike Evans and them building a connection, being a 1-2 punch. Should be a dynamic duo. They touched up on Jeremy McNichols. I didn't know he played for Snoop's Pop Warner League. It was cool. It was cool knowing that they go back and Snoop's active in his life and it's giving him motivation. I'm excited to see him play Friday when we have our first preseason game. I hope he gets his sense of direction down because that seems to be his only weakness. But other than that, him being a receiver coming in college and then turning on a running back, that's a lot of versatility. He should be much better than Charles Sims. Another player that caught my attention, Riley Bulla. Man, that guy is a character. He's the third string Mike linebacker, but I see that guy possibly working his way to the final roster. Not because of his personality, of course, but from what it was looking like and Dirk Cutter shouting him out, he should at least make the practice squad, if not somewhere on the 53-man roster. And, excuse me, they touched up with Mike Evans and how he was excited to see where this team was going compared to when he started to where they're going now. Dirk Cutter touching up on a lot of things and what needs to be built. He was not shy at coming at Jameis. This goes to show that no matter who you are, you're gonna get what you get. You can be the greatest quarterback. He could come off a great year. You're still gonna get talked to like any other player. I don't care who you are, and obviously the coaches don't either, because it's a business at the end of the day. I also liked how they showed the practice facility being built up and the progress of it. The special teams coordinator made a great analogy with what it takes to build a team and to come together. It worked out very well, and everything. And he had a great story with that. The talent show was good. It was pretty funny with the singing. Chris Godwin was good. He had a good voice. But Justin Evans needed to work on his pipes. Other than that, y'all let me know what y'all thought about the premiere. I'm excited for the rest of this season. I'm definitely excited for the preseason game Friday. I'm not looking forward to next episode because that's where we see the infamous Miko Grimes. I'm not looking forward to it. Until then, always and forever, Bucs gang, Buccos Locker. Travis, I'm signing out. Like, share, subscribe. Haters, I see you. Fuck you. Peace.